It is happening as we speak. Things are changing. Some looks positive, but some of them are really not that great. But what you have to understand is at a time when the market shows you that it's going to break to the upside, this is the altcoin market cap showing you that sign when Bitcoin dominance is dropping. Right? We discussed through that. This is the greatest indicator for you if you are in altcoins, because this is the time when you see the market is bouncing back. Most of the alts are in green. Now, what do I mean by an altcoin run up? Here you see the market is generally 4.9% up. Bitcoin is 4% up. Great. Now, if you go look at different assets, you can see various different numbers. See DOT 11%, UNI 9%, you know, all the different numbers. Now, when it comes to XRP, you need to look at the change in volume. I've been talking about this for some time, and look at the volume in Binance now. It's 12.37%. Remember, within last month when we discussed about this, it was like 25%. Now it's 50% less. So be careful where you are, because you want to make sure you are there on the right coin with the right volume so that you can take your profit at the right time, because we are having this technical stuff showing you we are going to break to the upside, and that's going to be an epic run to the upside. As you zoom in, you're looking at the micro scenario. You all know that, and that itself is getting bullish. When you step back and see the macro is getting, you know, even bullish, it's bouncing from the support. Then you take a step back and look at this, like, okay, we had this trend, U curved around bottom, and it's bouncing, and your target goes some way towards $6 to $9 if you extend this one. So what can you actually expect from the market when XRP USD is showing that, and XRP BTC is having this engulfing pattern, and on a forward you get a bullish flag there. Now, at the same time, when you step back on Bitcoin, now this is to take away the confusion here, because people would think Bitcoin is going to drop. Nah, it's not going to do that. If it's following this pattern, it definitely is going to go towards the next level of resistance. As we just highlighted, Bitcoin is going to go through. So as it continues higher, what you are eyeing at is this level of resistance, which it was stopped recently. Now, if we are able to break through that, then we have a moving average here, which again would be acting as a resistance. But if you look at the distance between these two moving average, when the distance is higher, that's when the price moved through the moving average. Say if you are looking at that on a technical perspective, you can kind of look at this like, say whenever you see the moving average, say trend like this, and the distance is huge, the price has less resistance to go through. But if you think like, say the moving average is like this, at here in this point, price get resisted, it goes back. But here at the area where the distance between the moving average is maximum, the price tends to go through that. So that's kind of a positive thing which you are looking at the market as of now. And to keep that into perspective, you definitely need to look at the macro scenario where you're like, okay, fine, this is going to break higher, and I'm going to look at this. Great. So as it breaks above this range and the moving average, what you are looking at next is $50,000. Now, that $50,000 mark when Bitcoin is continuing and you're getting a drop in altcoin, that's generally great for the altcoin market, because in the altcoin market, you're waiting for a breakout. So when this break above here, that shows you it was in a corrective mode. It broke above that pattern, it broke above the moving averages. Now it come back to the moving average zone and it's bouncing. So when it's bouncing and breaking out, you're getting this one in the dominance and Bitcoin moving up. So generally speaking, that come back to what we just spoke here. Market, when the market goes 10% up, Bitcoin may be 6-7% up, but a lot of alts would be 10-15% up. So being on the right coin at the right time, watching the right breakouts, give you that ability if you are into a lot of different coins. If you are not, if you're trading just one coin, it's fine, just follow that coin. And for us, mostly it's XRP. Say, for a daily chart of XRP, this is what we are looking at. We get a near to breakout scenario in the RSI. So we are trending high as of now. Now it's a daily candle, so you'll have to wait until the candle closes today and the next one opens tomorrow morning to see whether we are going to break out or we are going to continue inside this pattern. So until unless this is breaking out, we anticipate it's going to continue inside this. Now you zoom out on that same chart, which is daily, and you see like, okay, the macro scenario is like this and the area which we saw is this. So if you go back into that range, this is what we are talking about. With a double bottom, you went up, you broke above that. Now you're still getting supported. Now that level of support shows you we are trending higher. So here you got a higher low, then you got a higher high. Now, if it's bouncing from here and breaking higher, you're again getting a higher low, which itself is trending higher. Now the macro trend itself is trending higher on the same time frame, just zooming out, and then moving on to 3-day chart, you get this. We were trending lower, we consolidated, the accumulation range was done, we broke to the upside, we continued higher. So that's wave one done and entering into wave two. So if you are familiar with Elliott wave analysis, you know what's gonna come next. That's the wave two, which is the biggest wave. So if you just plot as per what the chart shows you, you can just look at if you're using a Fibonacci extension and you're a fan of that, that's great. You can just use that tool. It's not 100% perfect all the time, but it gives you an idea about what it's going to do next. So here you took this and the price more or less went above, fine. So next time when you are going to look at this, you are just gonna plot this one, right? So you take this, go to the top. Now we got just too much extended because of the CC, but again you came close to that, say 70-80% of accuracy. So if you are aiming for 70-80% of your target, you're gonna definitely reach there. So now the scenario is like, okay, let's take it from the top to the bottom, which we went recently, and look where we're gonna go. So yeah, $6 to $7 what it's showing. So the possibilities are like last time, we may get extended above it. So that's like $8, $9 mark. Then if it's going to slow down, we may still be able to reach here, which is like $6 mark. So if you are taking profits at the right points, in right percentage, you are going to still be liquid and be able to buy back if it drops and continue within this market cycle. Now that's not wave two. That's the impulsive move which we are anticipating because the market is trending like this. Fine. Now, what about the impulsive wave? So that's the Elliott wave two. Now, a lot of people are confused about which is wave one, which is wave two. So always I say, if you're gonna look at macro wave structure, you need to definitely look at what you are eyeing. So that's macro scenario. Here you got a support range, which was trending like this. And then that started acting as a resistance. So the resistance zone comes here. So now if you actually plot plot a rectangle where you kind of see the support resistance zone, that acts like this. So you were going down, this is your accumulation range, break above the accumulation range, came back there, it's getting retested and bounced, then it did this. So that's your way one. Now I understand a lot of people would have doubts about this. How can that be, right? You can go into any different asset and you'll be watching the same, any asset which has already done three waves, the historical fluctuations where you have most of them, if they were having a lot of traders, are going to show you the same pattern. See, if you look in the macro perspective, you see like, okay, wave one, two, three. But if you zoom in, you'll have a doubt whether this one is wave one, which it is not. But if you look at this, you had that range where you were being tested, you were under accumulation. But if you look at this, you came into capitulation, rounded bottom, you broke above that first one, and then you consolidated in that range. Now in between, we in this cycle XRP, this drop was so huge because of SEC. Otherwise we would have stayed in the same area like a lot of different coins like IOTA and others, and then continued higher. So this is not wave one here, rather this one is wave one after that. So in XRP, coming back onto that, you kind of get that perspective clear. Great. So that means this was not wave one, rather this one was, and that gave you like 10x. Now what are you going to look at? In XRP, wave two was so huge, and if you want to compare with the same chart which we just discussed, up CACON USD. So when you go back there, what you can look at is, like, say for example here, the ultimate wave one, as we call it, was like 5000%. Okay, great, cool. But we took it from the bottom of the breakout there. So now we plot it to the upside here. Now we come back to the real wave one. Yeah, so that's like 1500%, 1500%, and you got like 10 times that in wave two. So that's why we always say never miss wave two, because it's the biggest wave. You can calculate and say, okay, this is gonna happen, but sometimes it happens 10 times, it happens 80 times, 85 times, because we have an example here in last cycle where we did like 130, 140% to be precise, if you get the exact top and bottom, and you just did 8500%. So that's like 1:85 ratio there. So we are just talking about 2 to 3, right? So if you take that into perspective also, you're gonna reach somewhere like this, say 30x from that recent bottom. So it takes us somewhere around $15. Now we are not counting any extension like these crazy extensions, right? So that's also need, that should also be considered, because you know there are a lot of different reasons why we have our plan of taking profit little by little, percentage by percentage, as we continue higher, because that's going to keep you in a pace where you are slowly taking out profit as you go up. You are de-risking your portfolio, and when the price gets extended where we don't know it's going to go 24, 26, 30, whatever, you're still liquid and taking profit. It's not like you're running out of your units. So that's going to help you massively by the end of this market cycle. So as you move through wave two towards the correction of wave two, make sure you take profit, because you do have to understand after wave two comes 6, 7, 8 months of consolidation. And if you are ready to stay through the market, stay put when it drops 50, 60% by keeping your emotions under control, that's fine. You don't have to, but it's going to be really hard to understand wave three. So for me, taking profits is really important, and we as a group does that. So you want to look at different ideas, different charts for different assets, you can look at the Patreon. And right now, if you're actually receiving value, you can hit that like and subscribe button, which supports the channel a lot. Now guys, do understand, as you continue higher in wave two, you're going to take profits, you're going to look at the volume. When the volume is coming back up, you're going to start this one. When the volume is going to drop, you know that here the key area shows you the increase in selling power. So it's going to come here at the top two. We don't know whether it's $15, we don't know whether it's going to be $30, but we are prepared, right? As we continue higher, we would be still taking profits and preparing our portfolio, so that as you continue higher, you are rebalancing your portfolio into liquid areas. You can look at different asset class when you're taking 50, 30x, 40x, 50x in profit, because those who came in, now don't say 0.15, I'll take it to 0.25, because majority, for the majority in our Patreon, you know, the group has an average around 0.25. So when you come to this $15 mark, now we are 60 times up. It's not that $20, $30 we are looking at right now, it's just 15 and you're 60x up. So keep your units there, have patience, because when you're going up, you may see other assets doing great in the meantime, and then your ROI reduces. Why? You entered there late. If you had the average lower, it's great, because we have members who have average below 0.2. We have members who, you know, were so precise on these inverse head and shoulder, where they bought in at 0.16, 0.17. They still have a ton there, so the average is way low, 0.18, that region. So for them, it's going to be massive, because if you take it here, that's like 80 to 100x, and we continue higher, right? It's $20, $25, $30. We don't know. Wherever we are going to continue, we are going to definitely take profit. Now, when you jump back into different charts, which we discussed, you also need to understand Bitcoin will also move higher, but the difference being alts are going to pump. So you take that into perspective. If you're trading XRP BTC pair, you're looking for a rise to this resistance first. Once you break through that, I'll give you the update what we are looking at next, what we are going to eye next, right? So here in BTC 50, then 58 to 60 is what you're eyeing at. So keep that into mind as you trade up, because when you go higher, you definitely need to deleverage and look at the chart and see which asset is going to break higher, because right now we are having like 3-4 assets breaking to the upside. Now, it's not XRP, we are waiting for a breakout in XRP, but a lot of people in our Patreon are taking benefit of those. We are going through and showing you which asset is breaking out, what's your target, where you should enter, where you should take your profits. You know, this is something which you really need if you are trading. If you are an investor and you know what you're doing, then you definitely don't need this. Now, if you need this, you can look at the description. The link of Patreon is in that. And again, if you liked the content, please do support it. Channel, hit that like and subscribe button. I'll meet you guys on the next video. Bye for now.